Welcome to Poland Daily Culture. On today's episode, we're here in central Poland in the little city of Łowicz. Behind me is the Łowicz Ethnographic Museum. We're going to be showing you around the museum and all the sites inside. So you're going to find a lot more about Polish traditional culture. So join us on another fascinating journey around Polish culture.
One of the monuments of Łowicz culture, from architectural monument and historical mementos to folk art, is the museum in Łowicz. It is located in the former seminary, designed by Tilman from Jemeren and erected at the end of the 17th century by the primate Michał Radziejowski. The museum sets out to inspire the visitors and sensitize them to the past and current traditions of the region by the means of exhibitions, cultural events and educational activities. The history of the museum collection in Łowicz dates back to the turn of the 19th century and 20th century and is strongly connected with Władysław Tarczyński, a collector and a social worker. He made his collection available to the public in 1905 and called it the Antiquities Collection. The museum developed rapidly. It owned over 3,200 exhibits and a library until the outbreak of the First World War. Władysław Tarczyński also included objects and tools from the field of ethnography in the historical artistic collection. The Ethnographic Museum of Polish Tourist Society opened in 1910 and based on the collection of an outstanding social worker, Aniela Chmielińska. The collection of the Municipal Museum and the Ethnographic Museum was originally located together in a building purchased for the museum purposes at 16 Stary Rynek Street, which was opened to the public until 1939. The period of the Second World War caused subsequent losses in the museum collections. The National Museum in Warsaw took over both collections in 1948 and formed its department. Connected collections were given a new residence in a reconstructed religious building dated from 1689. Owned by the Cardinal Michał Radziejowski Foundation, the branch of the Baroque art in Poland is situated in a former primate chapel dedicated to Saint Karol Borromeusz. It is an original flank of the 17th century building, which wasn't destroyed during wartime. The interior vault is designed by Tilman from Jemeren and is decorated with illusionistic frescoes by Michelangelo Palloni, showing the life of Charles Borromeo, a patron, missionary and bishop of Milan. It's the best example of the Italian painter's artistic work in Poland from the turn of the 17th and 18th centuries. The paintings perfectly harmonizes with the stucco decoration on the vault and walls. There are also examples of artistic craft inside, such as furniture, fabrics, glassware, goldsmith work, porcelain, painting and sculpture.
Welcome to Poland Daily Culture. I'm John Carter and I'm joined by Mariana Wonka. Thank you very much for joining us here. So we're inside the Ethnographic Museum here in Łowicz, and I'd like to start off by asking about the significance of traditional Polish culture to Łowicz, because of course you have this wonderful Ethnographic Museum, you have the Corpus Christi Parade, and you have the Skansen as well, the wooden houses. So why is traditional Polish culture so alive in Łowicz?
I think that this is especially due to the fact that we are lucky to live in such a beautiful region. The fact that all these traditions are cultivated and maintained here probably results from the fact that they are so beautiful and worth cultivating, but also it stems from the upbringing of successive generations who were brought up in the tradition of the Duchy of Łowicz. The książacy lived here. They dressed beautifully, lived in beautiful estates. They made gorgeous decorations, cutouts, paper flowers such as those that are behind me. All this means that future generations want to cultivate it, and fortunately, this is how it works.
Could you tell us when the museum was first opened?
Początki historii muzeum.
The beginning of the museum's history is in the beginning of the 20th century. Władysław Tarczyński appeared here in the Łowicz region. He, as he said himself, collected antiquities and various souvenirs related not only to the Łowicz region, but also souvenirs from other regions and other parts of the world. He traveled a lot. He became so fascinated with Łowicz that he started collecting various souvenirs related strictly to Łowicz and created the base of our historical collection, the historical exhibition that is here, on the first floor.
So it was his personal collection, or he asked people from the region, could you send me some artifacts, clothing, etc., or furniture?
Początkowo była to jego.
Initially, it was his own private and personal collection of various historical mementos. He did, however, appeal to the inhabitants of the region that he would like to set up a museum and asked for submission of various historical mementos. These would, for example, be photographs or various documents. We also have an interesting collection of black jewelry from the times of the uprising. There is a lot of typically historical things here, and this collection is the basis of our historical collection. What is interesting, he did in fact start working with Aniela Chmielińska, who in turn studied the region in terms of ethnography. She traveled in the villages and spoke to their inhabitants. She asked them of their customs, their rituals, and ceremonies cultivated in the region. She would ask what clothes they wore and how they decorated their living quarters. She managed to collect a lot of different items here during those meetings and interviews. In our collection of outfits, among many others, we have a lot of items from her collections. These two combined created a museum in Łowicz. In this building was their home.
In your opinion, why is it so important to keep this regional traditions alive? What's the purpose, the motivation?
This is our story, our culture. We must care for it as well as make sure the next generations are acquainted with it and know of these traditions. If not, then people will forget about Łowicz and its beautiful history, about the fact that it is known for its customs and decorations. This is why it is so important that we, as inhabitants of the region, keep this tradition alive.